Good evening, everybody. This is Jordan Mittler. I am the Northeast Regional Director here at Ditron and also the National Symposium Chair for our first National Symposium. We're very excited, and we're really excited to have Dr. Block kind of do an overview for those of you that are interested perhaps in attending our upcoming symposium at the Gaylord Resort and Convention Center in National Harbor, Maryland. Coming up next year, we're February 2nd and 3rd. It's a Friday, Saturday. And Dr. Block, in conjunction with many of the clinicians that are on this, have put this program, outstanding program, together. And I want to kind of jump in and tell you a little bit about Dr. Block and his background. Dr. Block, excited to have him. Dr. Block graduated from the University of Rochester, attaining both a BA in biology and a BS in biomedical engineering. He completed his dental training at Harvard School of Dental Medicine, receiving his DMD cum laude in a special field. And he completed his oral maxillofacial residency at LSU School of Dentistry. He remained at LSU School of Dentistry, achieving faculty level of professor in the Department of Oral Maxillofacial Surgery. And he continues to teach one day a week in the dental school's implant program. But now he dedicates full time taking care of his patients in his private practice. I'm excited to have him share his overview and his vision on this symposium. So I'm going to turn it over to you, Doc. Thank you very much, Doc.
Well, thank you. First, I wanted to thank Jordan and Oli and David and everybody else at Ditron to ask me to help coordinate this meeting. We got a lot of input from a lot of people. And in general, we wanted to create a meeting that was geared toward clinicians on clinically appropriate topics. It's not an infomercial, I can assure you of that. It's really going to be a very scientific program. We've got the meeting is themed, and it's just tell you how I like to do it. I've run the dental implant conference at AAOMS for 28 years, and I've run some of the programs at the Academy of Osseointegration. And the successes of those meetings has been based on the content of the symposium and the meeting, you know, the actual speakers and what they're assigned to do, and theming the meeting and having evidence based, and also having it very upbeat, state of the art, maybe a little future looking, but really mainly for the clinicians so that you could utilize this material. We're not going to do show and tell at the meeting. It's not that kind of meeting. You're going to see some pretty slides, but you're going to see pretty slides that have a major context of education. So, you know, that's really what we have. We've been able to get a pretty decent group of speakers who are world-class. I mean, these people have been all over the world. Some of whom you won't necessarily get to hear at other places. So this is a very diverse group. For the oral surgeons, you're not going to hear a lot of these restorative people unless you go to some of the restorative meetings. The perio group, that, you know, you're going to hear, again, the restorative people. There's going to be a lot of material for those people that do the surgery and the restorative in their own practice, which I think is pretty cool. I'm always asked by my patients, will you make my teeth? And I said, no, your dentist won't like that. So I tend not to make the teeth and do the restorative, but certainly I think the people that do that have a unique insight into it. So it's going to be a fun meeting. It's going to be at the Gaylord, which is a great resort. And we have it just a couple miles down the street from the National Airport. We did that for a reason. It's that you can fly in and then be there and then fly out. And so it's easy to get to. Or you can take a train to D.C. or you can drive to D.C., whatever, wherever you are. So it's going to be a nice centralized location. The resort's very nice. Everything is going to be self-contained in the resort itself, but it's close enough to D.C., and Georgetown that if you want to get out and do something, you certainly have time to do it. So it's going to be fun. We have a nice venue. Jordan has done a great job on organizing the venue and the exhibit area and tables and all kinds of educational benefits. The meeting actually is going to start on Thursday. Now we have a lot of vendors. The vendors that we have are are there for reasons. For instance, if you look at smart denture conversions or hybrids, those are groups that can facilitate your full arch prosthetics and make it very user-friendly. A lot of the things we're doing now, it needs to be time-efficient and cost-efficient and patient-efficient. So this is what we have. So we got a pretty good group. A lot of the instrumentation you see, people talk about it's going to be from H&H. This group is growing. So we're really pleased to have the vendors there. They're going to have some vendor showcases as well, so they can show you their stuff and how to use their methods and materials. That'll be mostly on Thursday. And then during the meeting, we'll have the breaks with the exhibitors, so you get a chance to intermingle with them and see what they have. And if you come with a team, then the whole team can go to these places together. So it should be pretty good. Now, just to go on the program, just to start it off, the philosophy that we have is the sessions are themed so that there's some continuity between the speakers. And we will stay on time. I can assure you that we will stay on time. I'm going to moderate the first one just to get it going, but we'll have some opening remarks. And the moderating is just going to be the next speaker is, and this is the title. You'll be able to go over and look at their own credentials and things in the different, online apps and things like that. That'll be available. So you'll be able to see that. But Ole's going to start off first. And the first whole session, if you could scroll down a little bit, is stay where you are. The first thing is going to be on this peri-implantitis issue. And this is getting a lot of play. And so Dr. Jensen's going to talk about the evidence base on who gets it, when you get it, some iatrogenic reasons to have peri-implant disease. But once you eliminate the doctor related things about putting implants in bone that doesn't make sense or in a bad position, once you get rid of all that, it really comes down to microbiological things. So Ole's going to talk about that. And then Dr. David Cochran, who, if you haven't had a chance to hear him, he's just an icon. It's going to be great. He's got some evidence based on some papers that he wrote. He has one paper that he wrote is just, I think, one of the best pieces of work that I've ever seen come out of somebody evidence based on. And he'll talk about how the microgap influences the microbiological arena and then why that creates peri-implant disease. And the reason that's so important is you need to know an implant system that has a very tight interface, and which Ditron does have. And so that's a precision engineering, and it's very important that the precision engineering that we're getting these days in our automobiles and the Air Force and aircraft and any parts that move is about 1 micron. So that machining actually can be taken to our dental world, and that's what's happened. So this is why the microgap idea and understanding of the microgap is so key. And then after Dr. Cochran does, and again, if you haven't heard him speak, it's a great opportunity. And then Dr. Weiss is going to talk about a very novel a method to treat an implant surface with an antimicrobial. It's a nanotexture thing. It's really a slow release. It's really amazing, but he's got some great science behind it. See, we're just going to put people on who have really, really good scientific methods. And so those two speakers, or the three speakers, will really give you a very good idea on not only why you get peri-implant disease, what you can do with the choosing the parts to decrease the implant disease, and then a future treatment that may be just very, very good. This material, by the way, is used in composites and other restoration materials, so to decrease infection. So it's going to be really cool. And then we're going to take a break because you can only listen for so long. And then there'll be in the exhibit hall, there'll be presentations done by the vendors. And so our commercial partners are very important for you to visit with. And then Dr. Mittler, who's another icon, he's going to be talking about, he's going to be moderating the next session, which is roughly an hour and a half. And we have two speakers covering really full arch. And now Dr. Simon Oh has got a very, very efficient manner of getting the patients in, doing what he needs to do planning wise, and then very efficient care of them So he's very productive in what he does, and he's going to talk about how you can reduce this relatively appearing complex thing, the full arch, to just a very efficient algorithm of a treatment. So I think that's one of the first things we need to do, is to know how to actually get the patients in and get them worked up, and how we do that without making it so complicated that it's not cost effective, time effective. Then Dr. Golden, who's going to follow him, is going to talk about how do you just choose on what design you use, whether it's an FP1 or FP2, which is, now I'm a surgeon, so I get in trouble when I use these terms, but basically it's a set of teeth without pink on it, or a set of teeth with just a little pink on it. Basically, it's a natural looking set of crowns and bridges. I call it crown and bridge, but the FP1, FP2 prosthetics are basically multiple single tooth implants that are linked together. That's basically what you're doing on this. And then for those patients that do not have enough bone, or the implants need to be back a little bit or whatever, you can use fixed removable. So Ed's going to talk about how he does that. And also he's going to talk about how he stages some of these cases, so he can preserve a fixed provisional in while you get everybody cleaned up and grafted and implants in certain spaces. But for some patients have a lot of disease in their mouth. So sometimes if you stage the cases, so he's going to talk a lot about that. He's got 40 minutes to do that. And then we're going to have interaction with him for about 15 minutes or so with him and Simon. So it should be, that morning should be a pretty good morning. You're going to learn a lot about how to eliminate your disease, but very state of the art, and also how to actually do the choose and full arch, but also make it so that it's very effective from a time point of view. So if you have any questions while I'm talking, you know, just go to the Q&A and ask. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. Or we can take questions later. Then this will be lunch with the exhibitors. It'll be right there. So you don't have to go out to lunch. In fact, we don't want you to go out to lunch. We want you to hang out, because we're going to start the afternoon right on time. And so the afternoon session is going to be really talking about using methods. It'll be shorter, a little shorter talks, and using methods that will enable you to do things that you want to do to create a more aesthetic environment for your implants and more precision. So if we can go to the next page on the program, we'll talk about the speakers. Notice these talks are a little shorter in length on purpose. And Dr. Gracia Alvaro, I don't pronounce his name right. I'm sorry. I apologize. He's going to talk about the single tooth and how to actually do a single tooth step by step, but making you see how easy this can be on a routine basis. We're going to talk about custom milled abutments that can be screw retained. So you can actually make a custom milled abutment that can be screw retained for crowns, so you can easily take it on and off. You don't have to be using cement as much as you think. Don Ross is one of the leaders in photogrammetry. And he doesn't use it on just the full arch. He uses it on everybody. Everybody gets it. And there are going to be more and more navigation systems with lights on them that allow you to do the photogrammetry, so to speak, using the pickups from the navigation systems. So now you need a separate camera or a scanner. You can do photogrammetry, or you can do the same method, which is imaging your case, and you can do it just with a regular intraoral scanner. Again, we're going to talk about the digital workflow. We're going to try to get away from stone models and articulators and wax ups. And we're going to really show you a lot about how to do it on digital, because once you get a handle of doing digital workflows, you can work up a case in 10 minutes, literally, and get ready to do it, or be able to mill a provisional, work with your lab and do whatever you need to do. And then after that, the next speakers after the break, I think are going to just steal the show. I really do. I mean, so Bach Lee is one of the premier oral surgeons around. He's so good, such a great thinker. And so I asked him to speak on what the perfect implant would be. What was his criteria for a perfect implant? We really don't talk about that. You know, the manufacturers tell you that their implant is the perfect implant. And of course you have to understand that they want to sell you their implant, and many of their implants are very good, but there are some subtleties to them. So Bach is going to spend 45 minutes on what's the perfect implant. And that's actually a pretty interesting topic if you really think about it, because that's going to help you choose what implant system you use. And there are a lot of implants out there. There's hundreds of companies now. and they all have their own little vignette. And so we're gonna show you, you know, what would be the criteria that you want to kind of list down. Is these are the things I need to do for my perfect implant. Now, it's very interesting in orthopedics, as an example. Most knees and hip prostheses are the same. If you look company, all the major players, they're very similar. So now the hospitals are choosing the implant, orthopedic implant, for the orthopedic surgeons, most of the time, what they can put in their hospital based on cost and efficient use of materials. So the perfect implant for orthopedists is not only the one that has great clinical trial evidence, but actually, and so it works, but also is cost effective. And as you know, if you look at all the different companies, there's a lot of difference in cost. So I think Bach may cover some of that too. And then we're going to have the CEO from Ditron talking. And by the way, they're doing fine in Israel right now. They're protected and they're doing great. And we appreciate all the support that people are giving them. But Ariel is going to be coming and he's going to be talking about how the precision engineering is done and why it's done. And this is something that I think you'll find to be incredibly interesting, because these parts are milled, and depending on how precise you make them, it can be more costs more money to make them at certain interfaces. They know how to do it, since the Ditron Precision is the mother company, so to speak, that makes all the parts for the Maseratis and Lamborghinis, Mercedes, and all the airplanes and all the Air Force. So they're used to making parts very cost effective at 1 micron interface, which is about the size of the bacteria. So it's gonna be good. Now, after we've done that, that's the end of the Friday scientific program. And then there'll be a nice reception, a cocktail reception with food and beverages and whatever you need then. But it'll end early enough so you can go out and go out in the city and have a good time. But we don't want you to have too good of a time, because we're gonna start the next morning at 8 o'clock. Now, the Saturday morning session is rapid fire type stuff. We found that to be a very effective learning experience, where you can take a topic and you can just rapid fire somebody showing it. So as you know, somebody can talk for 45 minutes, but you really get the base of what they're saying in 20 minutes or 15 minutes or even 10 minutes. So we're gonna challenge the speakers to actually do that. So I was asked to speak on transitioning teeth implants. So I'm gonna show you how to use teeth to stage things. And then we're gonna have somebody speak on teeth with labial bone loss, how they treat them, which is a great topic. The perfect central incisor, Johnny Schwartz, is just phenomenal. The guy is just so good. He's a master ceramist. When I talked to him the other day, because he's in New Orleans, we work together a lot. He says, "What do you want me to talk about? Implants?" I said, "Well, you know, implant centrals, but what's the perfect, how would you make a perfect central incisor? What are your requirements?" And that really is the basis for then where you place your implant based on what emergence you want and how you want the shape to be in the embrasures. So that's going to be really exciting. Then we'll have a little panel discussion, then an interaction. And then the rest of the morning we'll show up. And if we go one more page, Dr. Finger is going to moderate that session, which is going to be great. Bernie Dunson is going to moderate the next session, which is going to be, it's going to be fun. We're not sure who's going to talk about the strategic placement of the implants yet. That's still to be determined. Or are we going to let Aldo and Lyndon just take the rest of the morning, which we may do. Elderly Party is one of the premier prosthodontists that I've ever seen talk. He's going to talk about contour of the abutments to allow you to have good long-term results. And that's something that a lot of people don't talk about but there's more and more interaction now. Maybe people are talking now about the first millimeter off of the abutment shoulder and then on the implant shoulder and the next one. But he's going to talk about that, and he's going to show you cases that he's utilized with that and then cases he hasn't. And you can see the difference. So I think when you start seeing that, you're going to be able to take your abutments and design them with the appropriate milling and virtual work to have an amazing result, which is going to be very hygienic and long-term success. Long-term is key. And then that's what Lyndon's going to talk about. Lyndon is one of our premier thinkers. He's a dean right now, but he's got his prosthetic degree and his PhD, and great thinker. And he's going to talk about lifelong success. In other words, you put these restorations in somebody, and then, you know, I guess I'm getting old, because I'm looking at patients that are 30 or 40 years after I started treating them. And they're doing well. And there's reasons for that. I mean, a lot of it has to do with how they're restored, not this necessarily the surgery. But he's going to talk about what you can do to have lifelong success. Because, you know, if you have that 20-year-old and you put the lateral incisor implants in, you know, 30 years later, they're just 50. They're only 50. And they got a long life to live after that. So, you know, we have patients that are coming in that are 30, 40 years, you know, post-restored. And we really don't have much more than 40 years on any of these patients because we really did start doing this in the early 80s. So he's going to talk about that. And I think that's going to be just an amazing talk. And that will conclude the meeting. That will be the meeting. So then you'll have all afternoon on Saturday to either go listen to another debate for the presidency, or going to go listen to a courtroom thing, or you can go and watch the LSU football team win, maybe not. Or you can go just have a good time in Georgetown, or you can go home, you know, whatever you want to do. You can just hang out as well with everybody. So that's what I kind of wanted to go over. I know I went over it pretty quickly, but I think when you see the meeting, the way it's strategically placed, I like this meeting because it's going to be upbeat. It's going to be fast paced. It's going to be clinically appropriate. Not going to be show and tell. We really didn't have show and tell on this. We purposely chose our speakers who are not known for show and tell. You know, show and tell is, you know, show a really pretty case and this is really pretty and then no one can do it. But that's not the case. These are clinicians who are practicing the art. They're wet fingered. They're all wet fingered. Every one of them. Even Dr. Cooper is wet fingered. He actually does surgery and he does restorations and he's still doing it. So he's, you know, you got a lot of people that are wet fingered, and our moderators are very, very experienced clinicians who we're glad to see. So we're excited about this meeting. We really are. You want to try to bring members of your team. If you're a surgical person and you have restorative people, you want to bring them with you so you can team up on it. You can certainly do that. That would be great. If you're a restorative person and you want to bring people as well, bring some surgeons to bring them and show them what they need to learn how to do. So these people, this is going to be one of those meetings that I think you're going to remember for a long time. I really do. It's just going to be that good. So again, I'm excited about it. Our speakers, we didn't have any problem getting our speakers to agree to talk. They were excited about it when they saw the program, and we sent them the program and said, this is what we want you to do and where you fit in. And they're all like, oh, I can't wait. Thank you. So when you have speakers that enthusiastic these days, it really plays out. But none of the old guard, you know, just that much. We don't have that much of the old topics, old stuff. You know, we're not doing fad stuff. We're doing really very efficient management. So you'll get singles, you'll get full arches, you'll get immediates, you'll get provisionals, you get digital methods, and I think it'll be pretty good. And then maybe Jordan, you can talk a little bit about the packages. I'm just a scientific committee person. I'm just putting the beating together.
You know, I think I'd like to open it up, Dr. Bach. This is outstanding. I'd like to open up maybe it as a Q&A. Some people might want to ask some questions.
Sure. If that's okay. If anybody with a question, just fill in your Q&A and our moderator.
I'm just gonna open up everybody here. So we'll just have an open. So feel free, just give me a second. I think you got to do it. Okay.
And then the other thing too is as you're opening those up, just to if somebody one of the attendees, you know, who are listening has some ideas and what else they'd want to hear, I'd love to hear it because, you know, we may include that in this meeting if somebody, you know, for some reason has a problem and has to bail out. But also for next year's meeting that we're planning, we can add some of that stuff. So if you have a topic that is not in here that you'd like to see, we'd sure like to know it, because this meeting is not necessarily for me. I mean, I'm happy to be involved in it, but it's really for you, you know, the attendees. So
that's I mean, the panel discussions are a huge thing. That's what we really wanted to have. We wanted to have it really engaging with our attendees. So. So I opened up the floor for everybody. So please feel free to ask Dr. Bach anything, or maybe something you're interested in seeing at the symposium or learning more about. So I opened everybody up. So feel free to ask. And then, of course, if people, we're going to have more information, if people beyond the symposium, of what could be done, you know, just entertainment wise, if you're planning on bringing a spouse or a friend or somebody down with you, we're going to make that. Oh, I got somebody raised their hand.
Even Lawrence.
Yes.
Yes.
Dr. Lawrence.
Yes. Could you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, we can.
Okay. So I'm wondering if you're going to go, or there's going to be any tie-in with, you know, digitally transferring things like with a steric system or any other imaging or systems that are out there.
Yeah. And that, well, so we're going to have probably like 4 or 5 talks that are going to be talking about the digital workflow. And what they're going to be doing is they're going to talk about, they have to be careful on how they handle the actual software programs, but, you know, from a commercial point of view, but they're going to be showing you how you can very easily transfer that over to whatever program. Now, if you have a specific thing, let's say if you want the CEREC, you know, so you can mill it. So you certainly should be able to ask those questions in the panel. And if that's something you want, I'll make sure that some of the speakers know that that's a topic that they need to include in there. So that's great. Yeah, a lot of this is going to be workflow issues. So when you work up a case digitally and you're ready to roll with it, you know, how do you actually mechanically get that plan to a printer, the right printer, or to some of the ones that are already that you have, you know, whether it's a CEREC or the E4D or whatever, you know, whatever you're using. Certainly that's a very important thing. And there's some other printers out there that could be used as well. So I think that's going to be discussed by some of the people that are doing that. But I'll make a point of making sure they understand how to make sure that you know how to do that when they're done talking. That's a great comment. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Okay. Another thing I just mentioned is we're going to have laboratory partners there, and who better to ask than them as well, that will be in attendance to answer those kind of questions.
Okay. Great. Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Anybody else? All right. So I guess, Doc, I'm going to go on to I'll take over and I'll go to the next slide. Thank you so much for that great presentation. We have this recorded, so we'll be sharing this with for those that couldn't attend tonight. But
I want to say one more thing. I just saw in the chat, Eric mentioned that he'd been to the Gaylord many times, and it's really close to the MGM Casino. Great place mm-hmm. to go after the meeting. And great place. So thank you, Eric, for doing that. I know Jordan's going to love knowing that that the venue was great. So thanks.
Yes. In fact, you know, it's funny. I was recommended. We were recommended by several clinicians to hold it here because it's just an easy place to get to and just a wonderful facility. So we're super excited, and they've been super really great to work with. So looking forward.
I recommend you get your hotel rooms done quickly, early, because they're gonna we're anticipating a pretty good crowd. So I would get your hotel room. I'd get registered and I'd get your hotel room pretty soon.
Yeah. So I'm gonna jump into that.
Jordan, before I just want to thank
David Lee. There you go.
If you wouldn't mind, I want to thank Dr. Block for taking the time. He's really jumped in and put together a symposium. I love the workflow of this symposium, and I love how he explained it. The whole idea is to move fast, to give as many of the topics as we can. I also took note about the digital workflow. We should have a couple of vendors there that will be able to help with that. But again, I just wanted to thank Dr. Block on behalf of myself and Dr. Jensen for putting together such a robust and exciting synopsis and symposium, which includes a lot of speakers, and that was our goal. It's not just a show and tell. So thank you, Dr. Block, for that, and Jordan, for all your time put in for the symposium. So thank you for that.
Yeah, we're super excited and really pumped up for this. It's going to be a lot of fun. The Dr. Block, it's been really a pleasure working with you on this. I mean, it's been outstanding. So I'm going to jump in right now, and just want to, there's a couple of ways you can get registered. So let me just kind of, we have the cost here, so that everybody knows. It's $4.99, if everybody can see, to register. We kept it nominal. And that covers all the food during the symposium. And we do have a room block. So if you have your cell phone, I would just take that QR code, and that will bring you to a place where you can just say that you're interested in attending. And we will have Jessica Gonzalez, our inside sales manager, contact you directly. And then for those of you that are not, are new to Ditron potentially, and looking at some year-end opportunities, we've actually tied in the symposium with some of that, where we're actually giving we're waiving the tuition and as well as two nights hotel with one of our packages here. So we can forward this to you if you're interested in that. We're looking to do that. A lot of doctors are looking for year end. So we figured we'd just tie that into it if that's something of interest. But other than that, this was really amazing. I really appreciate it, Dr. Block, and everybody for attending. If anybody has any questions, you can reach out to, on the right-hand side, he says Jessica Gonzalez, who is on this call. Jessica, you can say hi if you're still on, so everybody knows.
Yes, if anybody has questions or is ready to register, please do not hesitate to email me or give me a call.
Perfect. Thank you, Jessica. And you've been outstandingly helpful for all of this as well. And a huge thank you to you as well. And thank you, David Lee. And thank you, everybody. So with this, I'm going to kind of end the call. If there's any other questions, and if any more questions for Dr. Block, feel free to email Jessica or reach out to myself. You can write down my number is area code 516-647-8090.